Hi folks, this is David Kwan, and in this video I'm going to talk about Final Fantasy XIII 2. And yes, there's a sequel to Final Fantasy XIII, which when I first learned about this, I was like, whoa, what? That's weird, you know, because Final Fantasy XIII was so not liked by a lot of the audience here in America. I don't know how it was received in Japan. I think a lot of people loved it, a lot of people hated it, whatever. Me personally, I have a lot of mixed feelings about Final Fantasy XIII. But I was like kind of surprised, okay, so they're making a sequel. And now, you know, as we all know, it's a trilogy. There's Final Fantasy XIII, XIII-2. And currently, right now, I still haven't finished, but I'm actually playing as I'm recording this video. At the time of this recording. I have not finished Lightning Returns Final Fantasy XIII, which is the third and final entry of the Final Fantasy XIII trilogy. But I'm still playing it, and that game, I'm going to talk about that game later on after I finish that game. But this video is about Final Fantasy XIII 2, and surprisingly, I really, really, really like this game. I really enjoyed Final Fantasy XIII 2, so much so that I actually have a platinum trophy on this game. Like, seriously, this is probably, like, the only RPG, or Japanese role-playing game that I have a platinum trophy of. And this gives me so much more pride than having a platinum trophy in Metal Gear Solid 4. Which is weird, because, you know, getting a platinum for MGS4 was also, like, super challenging and required a lot of patience. It requires 8 playthroughs of the game to get platinum for Metal Gear Solid 4, so I played a lot of Metal Gear Solid 4 to get that. But getting platinum for 13-2 makes me feel even more like, yes, you know, for whatever reason. Getting it wasn't all that fun, but just achieving it makes me feel so good. But this game is, I think it's a really, really good game, but I know this game also has a lot of mixed feelings. So, 13 original, I had mixed feelings because a lot of the gameplay aspects was just kind of like, a lot of people kind of rant on 13 as being like a hallway simulator, you know, it's so linear, whatever. That wasn't my main problem with 13, you know, I didn't really mind that aspect so much. Like, it's a very, very linear game until like the final 3 chapters of the game. And then it kind of opens up a bit more, a lot more actually. And so that was kind of the main beef with a lot of people. For me, that wasn't the main beef. For me, what was even more kind of bad was that the characters, you couldn't really choose which characters to play with in some sections of the game. In the first section, you play as Saz and Lightning, or Lightning and Hope, and Benil and whatever, and you don't really get to choose who is even the leader of your character. It was like so tutorial-esque. It's like, it was almost like the game was like, you've never played an RPG game before, have you? So we're gonna like just limit your choices until this point, and then we're gonna limit that choice until this point. So that was really bothersome to me. And then near the end, it was just like, okay, now I see that you're more used to role-playing games, so here. And it got super difficult. Like, difficulty spike just, like, jumped up ridiculously. So that I think that was a very weird thing for the game. It's also my main gripe with 13. When your main character dies, the party leader dies, it's game over. It doesn't matter if the other characters that are in play die. Are still alive, it's game over. That bothered me so much, especially in the later part of the game, where some enemies can one-hit kill you, and it's random chance, and you just hope that it doesn't hit your party leader, because it can hit any other character and you're fine, but if it hits the party leader, then it's game over. That was extremely, extremely frustrating. But that's really my main gripe about Final Fantasy XIII. All the other stuff that people complain about Final Fantasy XIII, it doesn't bother me as much. 13-2, I think, addressed a lot of my gripes with 13. And that's probably why I like it so much. Now, you only have 2 party characters to care about, and the third one, you can choose as the monsters you collect. You know, you can collect monsters, and you could level them up and train them, and you can have them as your third party character. It's just really great. I like that so much. And you, one of your characters in the party can die, as long as all your characters don't die, it is not game over, which is great. The game automatically saves, so there's checkpoints. It's just so much better. Like, and the gameplay aspect of it is a lot more freedom. The game doesn't, it's not like you can only do this in the beginning part of the game. You can pretty much do whatever you want to do, or organize however you want to do. There's customization, and you can choose where to go, because there's a whole time travel element to the game. And I'll get to the story in probably another video. But I just want to say my overall feeling with 13.2 is that it addresses a lot of the gripes I had with 13. Although 13 is superior in some ways, in some other areas, which I think many people who don't like 13 are going to be surprised that that's my reaction. But there are things about 13 that I really, really enjoyed. The best thing I liked about 13 is the character dynamics. Not necessarily the characters themselves. So I know a lot of people found the characters in Final Fantasy 13 to be annoying. You know, especially Hope and especially Benil. I know those two characters are the ones that people got really annoyed by. And Snow. Snow is my least favorite character. I hope you guys know. Snow is my least favorite. It's across all three games. So I'm playing now. I just beat the main mission that deals with Snow in Lightning Returns Final Fantasy 13, and yep, still don't like Snow all that much. I think Snow's character in Lightning Returns Final Fantasy 13 is probably the best rendition of that character in the trilogy, but still don't really like Snow. But anyway, even if I don't like Snow, I really liked how he interacts with Sarah and Lightning and Hope, especially the relationship between Hope and Snow is probably like, and the relationship between Hope and Lightning in Final Fantasy 13 is something amazing. And my favorite scene in 13 is when Saz meets Dodge, his son, and Dodge turns into Crystal, and there's this scene where Saz is about to kill himself. Like, that was a very powerful moment. Because Final Fantasy 13 has six main characters who have about as equal amount of screen time. They talk a lot. There's no one character that's like, this is your game, you know? It's not Lightning game. It's the whole six characters gets about the equal amount of screen time. So there's a lot of character interactions that happen with all the six characters. And I really, really enjoyed that. 13.2, that's where it is inferior in terms of 13, because it just has two main characters. Noel was a new introduction to the franchise, and Sarah, who was not really talked, who barely was there in 13 because she was a crystal for majority of the game. So you finally get to play as characters that you haven't really gotten to know very well in 13. So 13.2 is more plot driven, whereas 13 was more character driven. You know, because the plot of 13 is, it's a mess. It's a jumbled mess, and I could really understand why people did not like the story of 13, because it gets everywhere without too much focus. I like it just because it gets to kind of really interesting, thought-provoking areas, but it is all over the place. 13.2 is all over the place too, but it is more like, this is what's going on, and this is what we need to do, and this is what's happening, and it always alludes to the overall plot. So it's very plot-driven. But it's not a very character-driven game. Noel, I like his voice acting. He's very preachy. You know, he gives sermons so much. You know, and Sarah is just still naive, but kind of hopeful. Like, these are very cliche caricature characters, you know, that kind of talk to each other in a way that nobody else would really. It doesn't seem like an actual human conversation when they just talk to each other, but more like somebody that wrote them down. You know, it feels very scripted, you know, and so the character interactions themselves are not very dynamic. It just doesn't feel all that great. The highlights in terms of characters in 13.2 for me is Caius, the main villain of this game. Such an amazing villain. And it's really hard to consider him a villain because he's so, there's a lot of layers to Caius, and it's so powerful. Like, he's a badass, But he's very like scheming, and if you unlock the secret ending, which I did because I have a platinum trophy for this game, like it is powerful. Caius is one of the best characters ever, and Lightning is introduced slightly, you know, it's very small doses in this game, and I think that's great because when you finally see Lightning, I was just like, oh, Lightning! Oh my gosh, I finally like meet Lightning, and there's Lightning kind of narrating the certain sequences, and her voice acting is quite amazing. I think Lightning is a really badass character, especially in 13-2. The sequel, Lightning Returns, Final Fantasy 13, is all Lightning, and it's overbearing. It's too much Lightning. It's too much. Lightning is not a very interesting character to have that much focus. But in small, tiny doses, like in Final Fantasy 13-2, it's great. And so I always looked forward to hearing Lightning and seeing Lightning as characters in Final Fantasy 13-2. So I thought that was really great. This video is running long, so I'm going to have to do more videos of me talking about Final Fantasy 13-2. Because this is a long game. I have a lot of opinions about this game. So there's a lot for me to say here, but I'll end it here, and I'll continue on to the next part. If you guys enjoyed, whatever you guys think about Final Fantasy 13-2, or 13, or the trilogy as a whole, feel free to leave comments, ask questions, whatever. Cheers.